We find ourselves today in one of the most dangerous environments on the planet. This is the bedroom of my teenage daughter, and it's full of junk.
Dad, get out of my room!
Gotta go.
What is it with teenagers and curtains? They either don't bother closing them when it gets dark, or they never open them during the day.
Oh, that's my daughter's bedroom up there. It's 11 a.m, she's not in, but the curtains are closed. I mean, just why?
So SwitchBot have very kindly offered to help me with this little problem. They've sent me a pair of the new SwitchBot Curtain 3 robots, which are designed to turn almost any type of curtain into a smart curtain. Let me show you the curtains that these are going to be fitted on.
I'm going to be installing the SwitchBot Curtain 3 on these curtain poles today. They're quite wide, about inch or so in diameter, and the curtains have got these metal grommets, so they're grommet style ones that the pole just goes straight through. I was a bit concerned at first that the curtain robot wouldn't be able to pull these across the pole, because if I do that they do tend to get a bit jammed. So luckily SwitchBot have actually got a solution for that, which I'll show you in a bit.
There are two versions of the Curtain 3 depending on the style of curtains. My curtains need the rod version, but you can also get a rail version if your curtains sit inside a track. This is the main body of the robot itself, and then there's these arms that kind of clip in here like that. I'll do the other side as well, and then it just hangs over the top of your curtain rod. Now it goes behind the curtain, so it goes between the curtain and the window, so it's not visible from the room, which is great. And it just kind of rolls along the curtain pole, pushing the curtain along. Now this, in my opinion, is pretty clever, but it's not as clever as what they've come up with here. This whole bunch of plastic clips along the grommets of the curtains, and if you get the spacing just right, it helps to pull the whole curtain along. It's a really clever bit of engineering. So firstly, this is not a flattering angle, and secondly, if you've got double curtains like I have here, then you'll need to install both curtain robots at the same time. I'm gonna lift up the curtain here out of the way so as I can show you properly. I make it easier for me to fit it on the rail just here. You just take the first rod like that and hang it over the rail. Then this clips in with the logo towards you, but you have to pull down on that and that clips in. Time for the second one. Hangs over, pulls down, clips in, and done. If you have the grommet style curtains like I have here with these big rings in, then you'll need to install this special plastic clip on a chain thing. It's easy enough to do. It clips over the top of the curtain through the grommet, and the grommet sits on the plastic and the plastic sits on the pole. It gives it a bit less friction, I think. You do that for all of the clips. Go, that's three done. I do it all the way along so you can see that's pretty quick to do. You might have to adjust the distance between the clips to get it working perfectly. I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 beads between, but I think by default it came with 7 beads between, but a bit of experimentation will find that out for you. If you have the tabbed style of curtains, then there are adapters you'll need to fit for those, and if you have an extendable pole, then you'll need to fit the included adapter to your pole too, so as the robot can make it over the step. You'll also need to install these magnets at the closed position for each curtain, so it's like at the center of the pole for me here. They are a bit like blister plasters and quite thick, so you have to push them down quite hard to make sure that they're stuck on properly. Once you've done that, just use the SwitchBot app to install and calibrate them. It's quite easy to do, and the app will basically talk you through the whole process. In the app you can control their position, and if you have a SwitchBot Hub, then you can also set automations so as they open and close on a schedule, or using light levels if you have the optional solar panels. Did I not mention the solar panels? Oh, and you really need to get the solar panel. It's got this nice long dangly rod and it installs so easily. It literally just clips in the bottom
there like that. I mean, that's installed. It keeps the robot charged. This is a south facing window, so it's going to get plenty of sun. It hangs down into the window, so as it's got a good view of the sun. It's also got a light sensor built into it, so as it knows whether it's day or night.
For those sorts of automations though, you will need a hub, and your best option there is the Hub 2. This is their latest hub, and it supports Matter, which means you can easily link your curtains to something like Home Assistant. Matter really is the easiest way to connect SwitchBot devices to Home Assistant. If you install the Matter add-on and integration, pair your SwitchBot Hub with Home Assistant, then in your SwitchBot app, under Hub Settings, select your supported devices as secondary devices for Matter. Then they just appear in Home Assistant to control. But all of this so far is really not that much different to the previous SwitchBot Curtain 2. Well, there must be something new about version 3. Well, yes, QuietDrift. This new feature will open and close your curtains almost silently. So first, let me show you the curtains opening normally. Okay, so it makes a noise, it's not quiet. It would likely wake you up, but QuietDrift will do the same thing with almost no noise, and it does this by moving very slowly. Very, very slowly indeed. Let me show you QuietDrift. Stop the clock! Now, quiet drift mode will use up a lot more of your battery compared to normal fast mode. So whilst it is brilliant to watch quiet drift in action, I am struggling to find a reason to use it myself. Let's say you are automatically opening the curtains in your bedroom in the morning. You might want to use quiet drift so as to not wake you up, but your curtains are opening. Surely that will wake you up anyway, so what's the point? But let's pretend for a minute that you actually have a use case for quiet drift. If you're using Home Assistant and Matter, then you won't be able to make use of QuietDrift that way. You can use the SwitchBot automations if you like, but if you prefer to use Home Assistant automations, then you'll need to use the SwitchBot API. Go and check out my SwitchBot API video first, because you'll need to get that up and running before my next steps will work. I'll put a link to that in the description, and once you have it connected, come back here and I'll show you what to do next. We need to create four components in Home Assistant. First, we need a REST command, which when called will do the actual communication with SwitchBot's API. Secondly, we need a sensor to keep track of the curtain's position. Then we need a script to manage the calling of the REST command. And finally, a cover template entity to present all of this as a controllable curtain to Home Assistant. Edit your configuration.yaml file and add a REST command like this. If you followed my API video exactly, then your token and sign entity names should be good. Don't forget to make sure that this device ID right here matches the ID of your paired curtains device, which you'll find in your all devices entity data. Then take a closer look at this parameter here. Now this number one means that we're going to use QuietDrift. If you don't want to use QuietDrift, change this to FF in lowercase. To be honest, if you don't want to use QuietDrift, then you're better off using Matter, but perhaps you have your reasons. Save your configuration, restart Home Assistant to make sure the REST command has been created. Next, find your REST sensors in your configuration file and paste in one just like this. So it's just below where you created your all devices sensor. We create one here. Again, change your device ID there to match your actual device ID. All this sensor is doing is updating or getting the value of the position of your curtains every 300 seconds. Now we need to go and create a script, which we do in settings, automations and scenes, and scripts. I've got one here. I'm going to switch to YAML mode, but essentially I'll put this code up on my website so you can copy and paste it in. When this script is called, it will call that REST command that you created originally and tell it the position that you wanted to set it to. So that might be fully open or fully closed. Then we've got this little loop here. Now it'll do this 6 times, it'll wait 30 seconds, and then it'll manually try and update the curtain position. Now, what do we do next? Oh yeah, finally, we go back to File Editor. If you look down here, you'll see I've got a template cover entity right here. Now this does a few things. First of all, it'll call that script we just created and tell it the position. Now it inverts the position because the way that SwitchBot uses positions and Home Assistant uses positions is different. It's like, I think it's 0 for open, 100 for close, whereas it's supposed to be the other way around for one of them. I can't remember which way around it is. You'll figure out. This works anyway. And then we have a little bit of funky templating here to filter out any values, because sometimes it might sit at 96% open when it's actually fully open. So all I do is say anything above 95% is actually 100%. Same for at the bottom, anything below 5% is actually 0%. Once you've added all that config in, save it, restart Home Assistant, and then you should be able to add an entity to your dashboard. So here I've added it as a little card. If I click on that, I can actually see it's closed right now, but I can set it to 53% there, and eventually that will update. It will take 30 seconds or so to check the position, but it will update. Well, have these solved my initial problem? Mostly yes, they have. I have the curtains set to close automatically in the evening at sunset. They're basically added to the same automation that all of my blinds and blind tilts are included in. In the mornings though, I still have them in manual opening mode because my daughter wasn't happy with the idea of being woken up by sunlight like some sort of adolescent vampire. What I can do now though is check whether or not they have been opened without physically entering her room. As a bonus, I also added the curtains to our away routines. So for a week while we were on holiday, the curtains were opening and closing totally automatically to help give the house a more lived-in look. Anyway, I hope you found this interesting. If you did, then please give the video a like, and I'll put all of the configuration up on my website and a link to that down in the description. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel too. Thank you for watching. Goodbye.